पास्ट एंड प्रेजेंट एंड पास्ट, सॉरी सॉरी, इट इज यूनिट नंबर 3, लिविंग वेयर वी लिव. यस, दैट इज यूनिट नंबर 3, वेयर वी लिव. ओके, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द थर्ड लेसन, दैट इज प्रेजेंट एंड पास्ट. पास्ट एंड प्रेजेंट, यू नो दैट द थिंग्स दैट आर ओल्ड, वेन वी टॉक अबाउट इट, द टाइम दैट इज इन द पास्ट, द एंशंट टाइम, वी टॉक इट इन पास्ट टेंस. एंड the whatever we are doing in the present time, we talk in present tense. But here we are going to discuss about the cities or the towns or the villages where the people were living in the past and how they are living in the present, right? You all people are living in the city of Lahore, right? So if we look and either we ask from the parents that how they were living in the past, what the things they were using in the past, how was the city in the past. So if I ask you that, most of you are, I think, 10 year or 11 year old. So if I ask you what are the changing you can see in your city, right? So can you tell me some of the things you can see that are change in your city over the period of time? Okay, I think yes, technology is changed, very good. Shopping malls are there, very good. Okay, now we are on page number 14. Page number is 14. 40, sorry, 40 page. Now I am showing you few of the slides in which you can see some of the things that are that were in the past and the things that were in the present, and you can make a comparison of the times. Now look at the slides. Two of the slides are in front of you. You can see that the old railway train which was used in the past and the new railway train that is used nowadays. Now you can see the railway station, Lahore railway station. You can see the vehicles that are standing outside, that there is a tonga, right? But in the present you cannot see a tonga. Instead of tonga, you can see a chinchi rickshaw. Rickshaws are there, cars are there, but in the present you can see a chinchi rickshaw instead of a tonga. Now there is a view of your mall, Lahore Mall. You can see that building in the past and the building that is in the present. Now you can see that there is a difference. Can you find that difference? There is a difference between both of the pictures. Can you find the difference in both of the pictures? No, the view of that road. If you look at the road, you can see the difference. There is a difference. Okay, we'll talk about it later. Now move to we'll going to move to the next one. You can see the view again, the view of the old Lahore and the view of the new Lahore. In for the local transport, earlier there was a double decker bus that was used for local transport, but nowadays you can see your metro buses, right, for the local transport. Okay, now we have to come to the lesson, and you can see that in the lesson, in your book page number 40, they had given shown you some of two of the photos of London. One is about the old London and the other one is about the new London. Okay, I'll play the track for you, and you will. This is a presentation made by Mia, and when you will listen the track, you have to keep in mind what wording she is using. I think I definitely prefer. I really like. In my opinion, we will talk about all these words later on. Now listen to the track.
Track 15. Part 1.
I'm going to talk about my city, London. These are two photos of central London, past and present. This is a photo from the year 1910. We can see the first cars, quite a lot of them. There is also a double-decker bus on the left-hand side of the photo. If you look closely, you can see the spiral stairs that the passengers climb to get to the top deck. I think I prefer these to modern-day buses. The top deck has no roof, so it must have been great on a sunny day.
Part 2.
In the present-day photo, we can see a lot of differences. There is a bicycle and some big black taxis called hackney cabs. There are double-decker buses in this photo too, but they are more modern. There is also an underground station in this photo, which means the streets aren't as crowded as in the older photo. And there are traffic lights, which means it's easier to control the traffic. I definitely prefer modern London because it's easier to travel around now as we have the underground, although I really like the old cars and buses.
Okay, children, you have listened the track, and you have already, the slide was already in front of you, and you have read the audio script also. Now, there is a question they had given you that which does she prefer, her city in the past or the present? In the presentation, which does Maya prefer, the city in the past or in the present? In Maya's presentation, she preferred the city. Yes, modern city. Right. Very good, children. Very good. Well done. Present. Okay. So the answer is Maya prefers modern London because it's easy to travel around. Now, there are some of the vocabulary they had given to you. You have listened all these words in the presentation. And you just have to tell what are the things that were in the past and what are the things that were in the present. There are some of the things they were in the past, and there are some of the things they were in the present, and there are some of the things they were present in both past and present. Right? You just have to give me the answer. Were the traffic lights there in the past? Yes or no? Have you seen the traffic light? Okay. Yes. Okay. Now come to the cars. Can you see the cars in the past? Obviously, there are cars and buses in the present, but the cars and buses in the past? Okay. Yes. Okay. Now there's underground. Underground means underground subway. Underground subway. Okay, was there an underground subway in the past? Yes. Huh? You heard that? Did you hear in the audio? No, it is only in the present. Okay, so there was no underground subway in the past. Now, horse-driven carriages. Can you see horse-driven carriages nowadays in London? No. Okay, good, Shamaya. Good, very good answer. Okay, the answers are now in front of you. Traffic lights, there were no traffic lights in the past, but they are in the present. Cars, okay, cars and buses, both in the present and past. Underground, no, there was no underground in the past. And there is no horse-driven carriages in present. Now we are going to move to the next picture. It is on page number 40. There, they have shown you some of the appliances, home appliances, and they have marked them with, labeled them with 1, 2, 3 and onward. So you have to just put them in correct order. The list is in front of you: washing machine, microwave, dishwasher, my mobile phone, television, iron, then cooker, fridge. Now, which one is the first one? First. Which appliance is on the first one? Yes, Beta, you can do it on your book just now. Mark it on the book. Yes, fridge. Okay. Come to the next one. What is the next one? Okay, good. Mobile. Okay. Then third one. Third one. Okay. A television. Okay. The next one. Fourth one. Yes, iron. Very good. Yes, hurry up, children. We don't have enough time. Okay, fifth one. This is washing machine. Very good. Number six one. Cooking range. Good. Cooker, right? Or very good, a stove. Or, okay, what is the next one? Number seventh. This is not a microwave. It is a dishwasher. Very good. Very good. It is a dishwasher. Okay, the last one, eighth. Yes, eighth one is a microwave. So you have successfully recognized the appliances. Now we are on the next activity on page number 41. They are asking you which home appliances did people use in 1910. So you have to think like this. I think that, I am sure that. I am going to play the audio for you, and you have to listen it very carefully, and you have to think about what were the appliances they were using in 1910. Listen it very carefully.
Track 16.
Part 3.
100 years ago, English homes were very different from homes today. There was no electricity, so people cooked on stoves powered by oil or wood. There weren't any dishwashers to wash the pots and pans, or microwaves to heat food quickly either, so life was much more difficult than it is today. There were no televisions. Imagine that! And no mobile phones. People washed clothes by hand because there weren't any washing machines, and some homes had oil irons to press clothes.
Okay, this was the track. You must have listened that in the past there was no electricity, so the people were cooking on stoves that were powered by oil or wood, right? And there were no dishwasher. There was no electricity, so they were using the iron that were not electric iron but oil iron, right? In the past also, in the laundry, people were using the coal iron or oil irons, right, to iron the clothes. So I just want to check whether you know what is the difference between opinion or suggestion or advice. Okay, so there are few of the sentences in front of you. You just have to put a tick. Tell me which one is the opinion, which sentence is has the expression of opinion, right? Opinion is whatever you think, Okay, I prefer traveling by bus than by car. Is it an opinion or a fact or a advice? Opinion, very good. Okay, number two, we can't take mobile phone to school. Is it your opinion or is it's a fact or a, okay, it's not an opinion. Okay, good, very good. Number three, I really like the old buses in my town. Do you like the old buses? Is it an opinion or a, yes, good, it is an opinion. Number three is an opinion. So number four is you should always cross the road on zebra crossing. This is a rule. It is not an opinion, right? So first and the third one is your opinion. Okay, now this is your homework. And this is an audio script. As I'm going to add it in your homework, as some of the children were complaining that their audios are not working, CDs are not working. So you can follow this one. And you can use this to answer the questions, right? This is a worksheet for you. You have they have divided the sentences into two halves, so you have to match them with the correct sentence. Okay, is it easy for you? Now this is again, and you have to listen to the that CD, or you have to read it, and you can mention that. Appliances. This is the vocabulary. Okay, you can write what are the appliances there. You can you have heard, right? This worksheet will be shared to you. Now this is an activity I'm giving you, as you have already learned about the verbs, and you know what are the present tense and the past tense. This thing you have already done in grade 4, 3, 4, you people are doing. So I feel so that you can easily do this. The first one I'll do for you, that is cook, cooked. So remaining you have to do at your own. And there is a little difference between in writing the past tense of all these verbs, as some are ending with a letter consonant, and before the consonant there is a vowel. What the rule you have to apply, then there is a word that is ending with an E. So what the rule you are going to apply. So it is just for your practice. If you don't know, you can get a help of the dictionary. In the dictionary part of speeches, a speech and the tenses are also mentioned over there, so you can get the help of the dictionary. It is very easy. Do it in your English B copy. Is it clear to you? And the first one, first activity is for your English A copy, right? Okay, I hope so that everything is clear to you. Is it clear to you? Okay. In first activity you have to do in English A, and the second activity you have to do in English B. Right? Okay. God bless you, beta. Is there any question?